What's up, everyone? I wanted to make a short video that's probably going to lead into much deeper, longer content over time. About the idea of healthy masculinity. You know, there's a term that's been thrown around in the last 24 months or so called toxic masculinity, a completely made up term that has no clear definition psychologically or scientifically in any way. And it's throwing guys for a bit of a loop. It's so easy to misinterpret the term to mean that any masculinity is toxic. Assertiveness, even aggression, courage, boldness and leadership, honesty. A lot of people are misinterpreting actions aligned with such values as always being toxic under this guise of toxic masculinity. And then on the other side of the spectrum from the so-called toxic masculinity is the nice guy syndrome, the passive, weak, overly feminine males out there who essentially have no balls. They don't initiate, they don't lead, they don't take risks, they're not honest, they're cowardly, on and on. And a lot of men are feeling really frustrated because no matter where they go on the spectrum, they are criticized. If they're too nice and passive, they miss out. And they're told that they're weak. And if they're too aggressive and dominating and self-serving, they're told that they're toxic. And men are getting very frustrated, like, well, what do I do then? I can't be anything without it being wrong. Well, there's something missing from this whole argument, which is healthy masculinity. Nobody's really defined this properly, or at least they haven't broadcasted a healthy definition yet. We're seeing some things come through now. One of the reasons guys like Jordan Peterson are building up such a following is because he's somebody who's willing to take a stand on what this means. He's been talking about honesty and keeping your back straight and taking responsibility for the world. He's giving some words and some definition to what healthy masculinity might be. And so I thought I'll have a crack at it, representing BROJO. And it's one of the pieces of work that BROJO is going to be focused on intently in the upcoming future. First, I want to lay out the spectrum for you that most people are on without realizing that nowhere on the spectrum is healthy. On one end, we have the nice guy. Now, in terms of masculinity, his masculinity is basically at zero. He is passive, weak, always a follower, indecisive, avoids risk, avoids emotional discomfort. He's very dishonest about what he thinks and feels. He only lets a little bit of himself show. He's constantly trying to take responsibility for everybody else's emotions, to control them into a state of happiness so that he feels good about himself. He seeks approval, he avoids disapproval. He has almost no sense of self, no real unique, authentic identity. He's merely a combination of all the influences he's experienced in his life. He's trying to fit a mold that everyone else has made for him. The nice guy is, at his core, very fake. He's trying to be what everybody else will enjoy, so that he can feel good about himself. On the other end, we have what you might call the arrogant, narcissistic douchebag. Controlling, Machiavellian, aggressive, will not accept no for an answer, crosses boundaries, disrespects others, is willing to make other people suffer just to gain material resources from them, is willing to psychopathically manipulate and deceive, to throw out an illusion, not to please people, but to trick them, to control them, to get what he wants from them and then discard them as a used resource. Bullies, assholes. And then we get basically shades of grey in between. A guy's more nice than he is nasty. A guy fluctuates between nice and nasty. We get that a lot. There's guys who call themselves a nice guy, but they're actually pretty fucking nasty with their behaviour. you know? And there's guys who think of themselves as a bad boy, but they're actually a people pleaser, seeking approval all the time, showing off to their friends, that kind of thing. I don't care if you call it toxic masculinity, call it whatever you want, make up whatever bullshit words you want. Nice guy syndrome, toxic masculinity, if you want to call it that, fine. But nowhere on the spectrum does a healthy person exist. Healthy masculinity can be defined as having one key characteristic that nowhere on this unhealthy spectrum does anyone have. Honesty. Bold, vulnerable honesty. See, the people who are on the spectrum between nice guy and toxic, or douchebag as I call it, they've got some things in common no matter where they are on this. One thing that the nice guy people pleaser has in common with the psychopathic player is dishonesty. Is using a dishonest representation of yourself to manipulate other people. That's what they both do. The people pleaser pretends to be agreeable and nice and friendly and calm and relaxed and unaffected and blah, 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 blah. He pretends to be all these things so that you'll be manipulated into liking him, into approving of him. The player pretends to be stoic, pretends to be fearless, pretends to be above everything, pretends to care about you when he doesn't, pretends by promising things that he knows he's not going to deliver in order to manipulate you into giving him what he wants. Sex, money and resources, power. They're kind of the same guy. They're both fucked up and neither of them has any version of healthy masculinity. This guy might appear to be more masculine because some of his traits mimic masculinity. Aggressiveness looks a bit like assertiveness. Brash bullying looks a bit like honesty. You know? Manipulative gameplay looks a bit like determination and courage. So he looks a bit masculine, but he's not. Now this is the guy that will break girls' hearts because he looks like a confident masculine guy, but it's a sham, it's a mirage. Underneath it is just insecurity and selfishness and narcissism, you know. And this guy looks nice, and people can fall for that, not so much in terms of sexual attraction, but friendship, definitely, trust, and reliability, because this guy looks like he has some of those characteristics. He looks like this is a guy you can rely on, he's a man of his word, he's a guy who's got your back, nothing bothers him, but that's a lie. What is healthy masculinity then, if it's not either of these things? The key is in the honesty. The vulnerable, bold honesty. This guy over there, this toxic guy, he might be boldly honest, but he's not vulnerably honest. He doesn't show his weaknesses. He doesn't show his hidden, needy intentions. He doesn't show the things that the holes in his armor, the things we can get through to him deeply. He doesn't show that. Right? The nice guy, he might have vulnerable honesty. He might complain about his weaknesses and his darknesses and kind of let you in on that, though often not. But he lacks bold honesty. He doesn't let you know what he's attracted to and repulsed by. He doesn't let you know how he really feels, what his true opinions on your behavior are. He isn't willing to polarize people into love or hate. So you start to get a sense of where the healthy guy stands out from this whole spectrum. He's not on it at all. He'll directly go for what he wants. He'll be bold, courageous, but he won't manipulate to do so. You'll know he's going for it. You'll know how he's going for it. And if anything he's done is designed to influence you, he'll make sure that you know he's trying to influence you so that you're not manipulated deceptively. But he's also vulnerably honest. If he wants to cry, he'll cry. If he's stressed, he'll tell you he's stressed. If he's confused, if he doesn't know what the fuck's going on, he won't pretend that he does. He'll let you see it. He'll present a full case the entire being of what he is, whatever happens to him in the moment, most importantly, he doesn't lie to himself. The nice guy tells himself that he's nice when he's really not. The nasty guy tells himself that he's determined and a winner when he's actually a fucking loser taking from people, a vulture. The healthy masculine guy goes, look, I can be all of these things sometimes. Sometimes I'm needy, sometimes I definitely want that and I'm going to go for it. Sometimes I don't know what the fuck's going on, this thing I'm really good at. He gives you everything. No shame. There's a lot of shame on this unhealthy spectrum. The nice guy, he's ashamed of his emotions. Well, actually, they all are. They're all ashamed of their emotions. They've all been conditioned into believing that a man should be a certain thing. So anything that doesn't line up with that, they hide it and suppress it. Boil it down until they fucking beat their wife or they get depression or want to kill themselves. There's a lot of shame in that unhealthy spectrum. But in this healthy spectrum, the guy is, he's Popeye. I am what I am. Sometimes I'm this, sometimes I'm that. Right now I'm this. I think of it as the forehead being opened up so you can see inside. Nothing hidden. But nothing hidden doesn't mean the nice guy who's just showing weaknesses all the time, because the nice guy has shame about his strengths. The narcissistic guy has shame about his weaknesses and is completely open about his strengths. There's some strengths in either of these guys, but the healthy masculine guy is just open about all of it. He'll say, I suck at that, but I'm good at this. I like that and I can't fucking stand this. You know, I feel happy here, but I feel sad here. I feel confused there. I'm a bit anxious about that. I'm all of these things, and by the way, all of these things are my responsibility. You don't have to do anything about them. I'm attracted to you, but you don't have to reciprocate. I want that, but you don't have to give it to me. I'm needy for these things, but it's my job to sort out those needs, not yours. This is how he's different. We're going to expand on this a lot more in BROJO. We're going to dive into it, and we're going to try and give you a clear understanding of masculinity. The difficulty is, it's not going to be a model that everyone follows to the letter. There's no rules to this. It's going to be different for you than it is for me, than it is for the other guy. There is no one way to be a man. Everywhere on this spectrum is this one way that people are trying to be or try to avoid not being, which is another strategy. But healthy masculinity is unique. It's genuine. It has integrity. It's you being you. That's all it is. Whatever sexual drives you have, being allowed to harness those, masculine or feminine. I want you guys to start thinking about it. I want you to comment below, email me, dan@brojo.co.nz, with your ideas about masculinity. I want to hear your stories about how other people's ideas about masculinity have fucked you up and what you need to recover and heal from those ideas. But I want us all to start something new when it comes to masculinity. We don't need feminists telling us what masculine is. Right? We don't need our abandoning fathers and mothers to tell us what being a man is. We don't need fucking movies with hyped up fucking roided out dudes shooting guns to tell us what a man should be. We have to decide for ourselves. We've got to take this one back from society. Each of us as a man has to decide what a healthy, integral version of masculinity is for him individually. Though I do believe we're going to have a lot of things in common. Tell me about your ideas. Let's build this thing together. Let's wipe the past. Learn from those mistakes. Create something new that's never been done before. Something healthy. Enjoyable. Something good. I look forward to hearing from you.